Welcome to this video going over the new text editor in Transcriptive 2.0. One of the main new features in Transcriptive 2.0 is the new text editor. And this tutorial does start with a transcript that's already been created. So if you want to learn how to do that, see our video on requesting new transcripts. The biggest change in the new text editor is that instead of having a tracking mode and an edit mode, there's just one mode that combines the features of both. You can click on a word to jump to it and then start typing to edit the text. Once you're done with your edits, you can press Control plus space to start playback again. No need to switch modes, it just starts playing, and then you can pause it again to make more edits. To add punctuation, just type that punctuation wherever you want it. Adding a period automatically capitalizes the first letter of the new sentence. You can delete spaces between words to combine them into one word, or press the space bar to split a word into two new words, and then press space bar after that to continue to add new words, which will all have their own individual time code. You can also right-click on a word to adjust the time code of that word. You have undo and redo keyboard shortcuts to undo and redo any changes you've made to the text. Press enter on a word to create a new paragraph starting with that word, and press delete at the beginning of the first word of a paragraph to combine that paragraph with the previous paragraph. You could delete words by pressing Control backspace or double clicking on a word and pressing backspace or delete to delete it. These buttons at the bottom of the screen allow you to jump to the next sentence or to the beginning of the next paragraph that starts with a new speaker. You can hover over these buttons to see what those keyboard shortcuts are. This is a fast way to jump around your transcript to playback or to make edits. If you want to change the capitalization of a word, just select that word and press the up arrow or the down arrow. Pressing down and up toggles between all lowercase, the first letter being capitalized and the entire word being capitalized. So it's just a fast way to change the capitalization of things like proper nouns. Transcriptive saves edits you've made to your transcript based on the autosave settings in the preferences menu. Here you can turn autosave on or off and set how many seconds between autosaves. You can also save by clicking the save button in the bottom left corner of the Transcriptive panel, and Transcriptive will also save your text edits whenever you switch to a different transcript, so you don't have to worry about losing any changes you've made when you switch between transcripts. The AI speech engines will automatically assign a speaker to each paragraph, and you can change the speakers using the dropdowns on the left side of the transcript. If you want to change the names of the speakers, you can open the speaker management menu from the top left in Transcriptive and set the correct name for each speaker. From this menu, you can also add new speakers or delete existing speakers and rename any of the speakers that are already there. This checkbox, change only one speaker line, makes it so that when you change a dropdown, it only changes that one dropdown and not any of the other ones. When you have that preference turned off, changing a speaker dropdown will change all of the dropdowns below it until the next speaker change. This option is just a faster way to change a lot of speakers at once if you're going through your whole transcript. Finally, you can use this X button to the left of any paragraph in Transcriptive to delete that paragraph. That's an easy way to clean up the transcript by getting rid of text that you just don't need to see. You can cut out small talk or questions from an interviewer. And deleting lines doesn't affect the time code of any of the rest of the transcript, so all of the stuff you do want to keep does remain synced with your clips and sequences. One note about the performance of the text editor: it's going to be more responsive with a 30-minute transcript than it is going to be with a 3-hour transcript, so if you have some really long transcripts, you may want to consider breaking them up into pieces if you're going to do a lot of text editing. And that's pretty much it for the text editor. Check out our YouTube channel for tutorials on all of the features of Transcriptive. And if you want a free trial of Transcriptive or of any of our plugins, go to our website, digitalanarchy.com.